एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन प्रेसिडेंट जया कल्लूर गारिकी अदर ताना एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन होल टीम की नेक्स्ट विचेसिन मन चीफ गेस्ट किशन रेड्डी गारिकी सतीश रेड्डी गारिकी तैतर पेद्दलंदरिकी ना ओक नमस्कारालंडि ताना एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन वाळ्ळंदरिकी प्रेसिडेंट नाकु अवकाशं इच्चिनंदुकु मी अंदर मुंदु चेरिनंदुकु चाला धन्यवादालु नेनु I'm delighted to participate today in this World Telugu Culture Fest organized by the Telugu Association of North America and other respected Telugu association worldwide. It is indeed heartening to see the celebration of our culture under the strain of current global pandemic. My compliments to entire management organized committee. Well, the fact that this cultural fest is being conducted virtually is a testimony of the extremely challenging environment the entire world faced today. The current pandemic has brought unprecedented changes in the lives, health and economy all over the world. Even without pandemic, we are living in a VUCA world, majorly due to technological disruptions. Today, life on this planet does not exist without challenges. In fact, to face the problems is a called life. You must learn how to face them and convert them into opportunities. It holds true not only for individuals but also for communities and national at large. If the nation is not able to face its challenges, it will be wiped out. If the community cannot manage its problems, that community, however powerful it might be, will vanish soon. Where is the Greek culture, Roman culture, Egyptian culture now? All of them are in our history books. They have been wiped out as the people at that time were not competent to face the problems that they were. On the contrary, our Indian culture, even after centuries of mindless invasions and ruling and exploitation, survived keeping our rich heritage and culture intact. Friends, you are all living in the most developed parts of the world. You are spread across continents. As today, we have association from 40 plus countries. You are the ambassadors of our country, culture, and community. You have this moral responsibility to protect our culture, always take pride in our roots, and hold our culture in the highest esteem. I would like to talk about our ancient wisdom and culture. I'm sure that you all know. And meek andaru telisindhe nenantha summarize chesi what is our culture, what is our ancient wisdom idi meek telisindhi okkar anni teeskochi nenu just whatever my this one is there with my limited experience and just I want to share before all this not only telugu kaakunda total and indian deni meda mark twain is the father of american literature what he says india is the cradle of the human race the birthplace of human speech the mother of history the grandmother of legend and the great grandmother of tradition our most valuable and most artistic materials in the history of man are treasured up in india only mana andhra kaakunda mottham mana bharat desham culture gunchi just I want to say some few things and we are also part of that today india has a glorious culture and civilization sustained over 8000 years indian culture and civilization and its thousands of years old living practices traditions to provide wholesome well-being happy and healthy living our ancient people have realized that fulfillment of basic needs such as food clothing and shelter all round education and sustainable lifestyle and peace in the land these wholesome practices and traditions have become the basic ethos of our civilization and india's cultural spirit For example, you can take the manu upasam anta kada. Fasting always been very important in intrinsic part of our Indian culture. We assume that it is driven by religious and spiritual beliefs because the real meaning we have lost in transfer from generation to generation. However, recent scientific research has shown effect of fasting on health and longevity. Japanese cell biologist Yoshinori Osumi won the Nobel Prize in Medicine in 2016 for his research on how cells recycle, renew their content through a process activated by fasting. It is scientifically proven that regular fasting has a miraculous effect on aging process, protection against dementia, Parkinson's, blood sugar control, reduced inflammation, weight loss, and improved brain function. What our ancient people made tradition have great benefits to human life, which science is providing in today's modern world. The other one is, I'm not in a religion or anything, this one. Just I want to see the scientific way what our ancients have done. That is scientific research is recently. The holy city of Varanasi is believed to be a replica of the universe or copy of the cosmos. In fact, Professor John McMalvel from the renowned University of Colorado, USA, have been researching for more than 2 decades with Dr. Rana P.B. Singh of Banaras Hindu University, who published the book on the cosmic order and cultural astronomy, Sacred Cities of India. He was shocked by the scientific and astronomical knowledge of our ancestors had, which they incorporated into the design. Other ancient temples like Chidambaram Temple and Hampi and the city of Vijayanagar also show the influence of astronomy and design and planning. All were designed with a perfect alignment of the earth movement in order to generate maximum cosmic energy. Much as alignment of our body's inner chakras lead to healthy mind and body, the orientation of city to cosmology has resulted in these cities being the most flourishing in Indian history. Similarly, the ancient art of building temples is not mere art, it is a science. Every single facet of it, from size of the idols to the directions and the sanctum, is highly developed science. The structure of the temple, the use of flowers, camphor, bells, prasadam, applying tilak, all these aspects have a scientific reason behind, which is now researched and accepted by leading universities and scientists. The temple and rituals as entering without shoes activates our chakras, enable us to absorb the powerful possible energy, thus aligning us with the universe or cosmos. Again, coming back to food, we all know that is the best one in the world. Ours is the best one in the world since we use so many herbs and ingredients that have medicinal properties. Even in the current corona pandemic, our food naturally protects us. And also yoga and meditation for the wholesome living by bringing body, mind and soul in complete harmony. Friends, not only our traditions, but our scriptures also provides great learning. Our Bhagavad Gita is the best timeless management book on the planet, which teaches us the leadership lesson through its 18 chapters. Scholars, politicians, scientists, inventors, corporate leaders, many of the great accomplished personalities from across the world have referred and taken lessons from Bhagavad Gita. Actually, from a housewife to leader, Gita teaches great lessons for every human being. It is not a religion or anything in it. Let me mention about Robert Oppenheimer, father of the atomic bomb. He admitted Gita was one of the books that most shaped his philosophy of life. He studied Sanskrit in Berkeley to understand the Bhagavad Gita in its native language. Later on, Bhagavad Gita became the guiding light for Robert Oppenheimer, bringing out the leader in him successfully. Since last many decades, many top US universities are having management lessons and classes inspired from Bhagavad Gita, including Harvard, which is having courses on Ramayana and Mahabharata. Unfortunately, we Indians have made just as religious book kept in the puja rooms. It should be studied to learn the lessons and implement in a day-to-day lives. Several Nobel Prize winners and great scientists from western part of the world, like Erwin Schrödinger, Wayne Werner Hensberg, David Bohr, Carl Sagan, Nikola Tesla, all have taken inspirations and learnings from ancient Indian Vedas and Upanishads. For instance, Cambridge University in London has a 1,000-year-old Indian manuscript written in Sanskrit on the palm leaf. Its title in English means The Perfection of Wisdom in 8,000 Lines. Friends, people from our land, even thousands of years ago, came out with the most advanced science that we are getting to know today. The ancient Indian civilization developed technique for determining true north that later developed into navigation system. A methodology for surveying geometrical grids was established. Number and decimal system was developed. Sound energy was implemented in temples. Writing was developed. A system of weights and measures was invented. Ayurveda and surgeries at that time were more impactful than even today's modern science. In fact, Dalai Lama publicly said that these Westerners are celebrating the so-called new concept, quantum physics, now. But Indian scientists has already developed these 3,000 years ago. India has given science to the world. As Albert Einstein admitted, we owe a lot to the Indians who taught us how to count, without which no worthwhile scientific discovery could have been made. When Queen of England sent Lord Macaulay for a study for India, after extensively traveling and studying in India, he submitted to Queen that he has not seen even one beggar or thief in the entire country and it is impossible to conquer India. The only way is to destroy its backbone, which is its spiritual and cultural heritage, and replace their ancient education system. This clearly shows with a great culture our ancients have built for us. I think most of the people of the 18th, 19th century, we used to contribute 20% of the world GDP. Our ancient wisdom, culture, and tradition are matchless. That is our DNA. And that is what we all Indians are made of. No surprise that if you start seeing the leadership of the top 10 companies in the world, it will probably be Indian. Whether it is a Microsoft, Google, or PepsiCo, or MasterCard, or Berkshire Hathaway, or numerous others. Their success is not by any chance or luck. Of course, it is their hard work and determination. But the fundamental is their strong culture and value system. In my view, the entire credit goes to our ancient wisdom and strong cultural value-based upbringing. Unfortunately, India was exploited and looted of its rich cultural heritage for many centuries. However, I am very optimistic because British people, when they rule 200 years, they rule just that. At one time, the three economic problems too, I have been discussing time for. But I am very optimistic that our time economic supremacy will come back because of knowledge economy. Today, more than 800 multinational companies have their R&D centers in our country. Many have their center of excellence established in India, and almost all of the Fortune 500 companies, in one way or other, are present in India. I can proudly say that today, no multinational company can survive without having a presence in India. One of the important catalysts is our present government. Under the visionary leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Modi ji, who is bringing great reforms, improved ease of doing business, strong decision-making and policies, is heading towards making India a $5 trillion economy by 2024. He has created tremendous trust and brand for India. The current pandemic is just a small hitch, but I'm sure we'll reach there sooner or later. The future for the world is India. We have all seen the response to invest you've taken the Jio platform recently with the Facebook, Google, Microsoft. Number of companies shall invest is almost so many billions of dollars has come to Jio. Similarly, you know that the progress in pharma industry is proven globally. I do not think any medicine or injection can be made without India playing a role in that. Taking in my case, like that, so many cases are there. Mari ippudu mana vidyapadi, I came from the small village near Visakhapatnam Raja. I started with a small trading family in Uchandu. All business before economic liberalization, I started with it. So many industries as entrepreneurs started. After they moved to a strategist, all the old economies were disinvested. Again, owed to building the institution. And whatever business we chased, only Kottave Maku. All businesses new, including airport, Gani, energy, Gani, everything. Even Hyderabad, Delhi airport, new to us, new to the country. But Delhi airport, we choose to renew our choice. It is a worst airport in the world. Irojni, number one airport in the world, in a service standard alone, global. And we are also now, we are doing in a the Philippines lo chestunna airport, Greece lo built and operated chestunna, recently Manila lo vachindi airport too. All airports lo we have an ADP, airport Paris company invested. I am not saying about this, this is all our Indians because of our DNA. Anything manu, we can easily understand. Our answer is wisdom, because you know, part of that we can understand any type of this one, we can bring it to center of excellence. Yeah, now we are becoming a brand for the airports in the world now, where the top this one. This is what I want to say is the volume of our culture, our DNA. And also you are all in globally, you are in different positions, different sexual life, because of our DNA. Our DNA of our ancient wisdom, all in our DNA is there. Today, you are building with that. With this ancient wisdom, what I want to say is, we must be proud of our culture. Today, the next generation, they are not feeling our culture. Either man Telugu gani, labbadu man Bharatiya culture gani, man next generation, we have to be proud of our culture and the pride and proud of culture, and also we would keep our culture into intact. We cannot bring the next generation of our culture. This is our duty to bring back to our culture and be proud of our culture. This is only I want to say to it. And also, we are in such a situation today, the pandemic, coronavirus, and also we all know that we are living in a VUCA world, and this type of unexpected is coming to in the future also. And this is the only way our the ancient system, yoga and meditation, that is the only way to come out. Anything, what they say, then coronavirus kala, a bhai one of the immunity, a fear. What I learned from one of the Vivekananda book, they say, whole Vedas and Bhagavad Gita says one word, fearless. A fear under the one of the immunity. The whole thing, rightly they mentioned that, if a fear is there, we cannot do anything at this. That is a reducing the immunity. And thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Only I want to say that about our ancient wisdom. You are all protector of this. Wonderfully, you are organizer this. At this juncture, you are organized. Thank you very much for giving opportunity for me. And compliment the entire team for your organizing at this time of this. Bringing to our Indian values, Indian culture, particularly mana Telugu bhashanu meeru cheyadaniki naaku dhanyavaadalu andi. Naa Telugu gurinchi em cheyalani adigaanu, but I don't have any idea. Ippudu entha Delhi lo unnam kaabatti, it's not that our roots are in Telugu. Everything, we never forget our village. Every Pongal Sankranti keltam, Sankranti celebration anni chestuntam. Whatever your association, anything is there, we are fine. మన తెలుగుదానికి మన ఆంధ్రాకి మన తెలుగుకి వి ఆర్ రెడీ టు డూ ఫర్ ఇదండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ టు గివింగ్ ఆపర్చునిటీ ఫర్ మీ. థ్యాంక్ యూ.